Hey everyone, it's Kothis. Today is Thursday, which means it's time to figure out what is new in the world of Destiny with the weekly TWAB. Just like last week, not too much to go over, but there are some good bits of news in here. By the way, I've got a full stasis guide coming out in the next couple days, so be on the lookout for that. I'm pretty excited for it. Alright, back to the TWAB. Let's get right into it. First up, some good news regarding the deep sight weapons from this season, or the pirate-themed weapons. The double perk weapon upgrade on the star chart will now give you a guaranteed deep sight weapon of your choice once per week. This is once per account, by the way, not once per character. The double perk option was completely useless in my opinion because the end goal of these weapons is to just craft them. So having a double perk weapon is cool, but a waste because I'll just craft it at some point. Also, the hidden compartment crew upgrade will now do what it was supposed to do initially and reset weekly, giving you a random red border every week on your first catch crash completion. Again, once per account, not once per character. This month's Prime Gaming drop has a few cool items to pick up. If you've got Prime Gaming, just link your Bungie account and pick up these rewards. Super easy, and free loot is always nice. Grandmasters. Oh yeah, it's time. We have a tough season ahead of us here, so it's time to finish grinding up to 1595 and get some killer builds going. If you didn't know, this season we have the Glassway, the Lightblade, Fallen Saber, the Disgraced, Exodus Crash, and the Devil's Lair Strikes to grind. Each one will only be available for 1 week at a time, so if you miss it, you are going to miss out on the weapon. By the way, this season's weapons are the Duty Bound, Silicon Neuroma, Militia's Birthright, DFA, Horror's Least, and Mindbender's Ambition. Mindbender's and Militia's Birthright are the two new weapons entering the Nightfall weapon pool, which replace the Hothead and Plug 1.1 from last season. These two new weapons didn't have the greatest perks in the normal version, and I don't see the adept versions we get from the Grandmasters changing people's minds too much, but I am going to be chasing the Perpetual Motion Kill Clip or Perpetual Motion Frenzy Horror's Lease though, along with a couple other weapons. There are some good ones in there. Finishing off, we have a couple other random miscellaneous stuff that we can go over. If you completed King's Fall by September 6th and have claimed the Triumph in-game, you have until tomorrow night, or the 30th at midnight, to claim your raid ring. Also, this upcoming Tuesday, October 4th, we have a hotfix incoming, so expect some more news from Bungie regarding that on Tuesday. It also seems there was some bad wording with the introductory seasonal stuff and accessing plundered energy. I didn't experience that, but if you were, try these steps listed here on the screen to fix that. There are a couple other known issues that Bungie is working on here too, nothing too crazy. All right, that is the news we have for this week at Bungie. I'm personally super excited for GMs, even though they look like they are going to be really, really tough, especially more tough than last season. Are you all going to be running GMs this season? Let me know down in the comments. Which one are you most scared for? Well, that is it for now, everyone. I will see you in the next video.